Welcome back to Context Electronics. My name is Chris Gamble, and this is a continuation of Getting To Blinky 5.0. We're actually going to be making our first footprint ever here today and putting in a new library. Probably not in that order, actually. So a footprint is the physical thing that we're going to be soldering stuff to. And so we need to actually sometimes make custom ones there where we choose a very simple one to use as our example here. It's going to be the same one we used in Getting To Blinky 4.0. And we need to make a library for it because that is where you are going to put your custom things. You can't actually write a new footprint into the default libraries. Those are actually write protected. And that's kind of a good thing, actually. We want to probably keep those separate. So I always try and either make a global library for my entire, for all of my projects, or I make one specific to this project. But let's take a look at what we're talking about here. So first things first, we're going to be making a footprint for the BT1. If you remember, when we go in here, this actually does not have a footprint associated with it. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to go back to the launcher here, and then we're going to click on the footprint editor. This is also available from the PCB new, but we're going to start from here. And now this has actually changed a little bit between KiCad 4 and 5, and this has actually gotten a little bit easier. So the first thing we're going to do is say new library, not add library, that's if it already exists. We're going to say new library. You see we're actually in our project directory here. This is actually what we've been working out of. And it actually just grabs the project name and says, okay, I'm just going to append.pretty, which is the folder that is used as the library. So library is really just a folder that contains individual files for each footprint. So we'll just leave that the same. We'll hit save. Now we're going to say we're just going to add it to the project. You could add it to the global, but I don't like doing that because then when you start a new project, then basically you're seeing old projects libraries in there. So I usually just do them on a project basis, unless it's a very specific reason that I'm making a global library, maybe for all the parts if I know I'm going to reuse them a lot. So I'm going to hit OK. All right. And now what we should see in this list, we should see the new Getting To Blinky 5.0. And here we go. So it is an empty library. Great. So now what we're going to do is we're going to actually create a new footprint in here. And there's two ways you can do that. One is up here. You hit new footprint, or you can right click on the library itself. And this is usually what I find myself doing. I say new footprint because I know that it's going to go right into this library. So we're going to say footprint name. This is actually going to be the name of the part that we're using. And that is this one here. So we're going to just copy. We just copy like this. We're going to call it S8211-46R. That's just a surface mount battery holder for a CR2032 battery, rather. So we're going to put that in there. And there we go. So now we have a footprint started. I'm going to just move this stuff around. Again, I'm just mousing over, hitting M. I can move stuff around. If I want to edit it, I can always mouse over, hit E. Edit the reference name. I can make it invisible if I want to, but I'm actually going to keep this here. This is going to be the BT1. If we had five BTs, it would be BT1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? That's what ref star star represents here. And now what we're going to do is we're going to go and we're going to open up the data sheet, and we're going to try and make the footprint from this. So data sheets often have footprint information. This is what we want to use it for here. You can see down in the lower right corner here. So recommended pad layout is what we want to start with. So we're going to be making 5.5 square pads here. So the center pad is the negative contact pad. This one is the positive contact pad. So what I'm going to do is go back and actually check just to make sure which one's which. I believe this is pin one. Oops, this is pin one here. So I'm going to right click. I'm going to go into Properties, Edit with Library Editor, and then see which pin's which. So pin 1 is positive. So, all right, so we're going to say pin 1 is on the outside, and then pin 2 is the negative one, and we'll associate it with the center pad there. So let's go back here. So we're going to do pin 1 on the outside. So whenever you start, first thing, you're going to actually create a pad and this is just kind of a generic pad interface. It always kind of starts with this through-hole pad. So the first thing we're going to do is going to drop it down here. Then we're going to mouse over it, hit E, and then go and edit it. So first thing we're going to do is make it an SMD pad because this is an SMD part. We're going to make it rectangular. Remember, a square is just a rectangle with the same dimensions. And then it's 5.5 on each side there. Just go and double-check that against the thing. So 5.5 and 5.5. You might say, well, how do I know this is in millimeters versus in inches? And you see everything here is, it says tolerances, everything is in millimeters unless stated, and that's usually what you're going to see there. If you see two different things, maybe you see 31.1 and then something in parentheses, that usually means that one's in inches and one's in millimeters, and you can kind of go and look at some of the drawing to see this. Now this is, I will say this is, especially when you're getting started, the mechanical side of things, like where mechanical part of parts kind of runs into PCBs, it starts to get a little confusing. It's kind of a whole new domain, and I still struggle with it sometimes, honestly. You'll see some of the math we have to do here, it's unclear why they do it the way they do. It's unfortunate how these are mechanically constrained. They're usually made because they want to make the parts and then measure them to make sure that they're well manufactured, and that's what the drawings are made for. But we're using them from an electrical perspective, so it can be kind of tough to equate the two. So we're gonna do our best here. We're gonna leave the position on this one, and then we're just gonna make our second pad here. So it says 4 millimeter square. So I hit okay. We'll just leave that there for now. I'm gonna hit pad again. You should see if I hit another pad, it's just gonna make, sorry, if I put a second pad down, it says, hey, you want the same size pad? We can do that. And we're gonna say, actually, we don't wanna do that. We wanna edit this again. We're gonna make this one 4x4. Okay, and that one's just gonna be right in the center here, right? So that's what we do know. We're gonna have this pad right in the center of everything here. And then we're gonna put these other pads in the proper spacing. Now this is where it gets kind of weird. It's like 31.1 to the outside edge. So let's do a little bit of math here. So first thing we're gonna do is we're going to copy this pad, and then we're gonna paste it. I think we can paste it. Yeah, there we go. That was weird. It actually grabbed all the text up there. all right, so first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna have to do a little bit of math. So let's actually make this to the side here, and then let's zoom this one. Let's put this off to the side as well. Okay. All right, there we go. So we know that we want 31.1, but we need that divided into, remember the center point is right here. Sorry, still zooming differently on different computers that I'm on. All right, so 31.1 from the center. So what we know is that we want to go from here to the edge is half of 31.1, so we could start with that, right? So if you mouse over here and hit E, we can actually do math inside of the dialog here. And that's actually one thing I love that about version 5.0 that actually changed. I have a whole video about how this has changed. But what we're gonna do is say 31.1 divided by 2. We'll put that in parentheses. And then we're gonna have to actually, so that's from here, from the center point here to the very edge of the pad. Then what we wanna do is actually go back to the center of this pad. So we need to subtract off another half of 5.5. So then we say this disappeared. So we're gonna minus 5.5 divided by 2. And then we see that's 12.8. Oops. So, well, we're just gonna put that back in as 12.8. We know that's 12.8 now, minus 12.8. Let's zoom out a little bit to see what it looks like. So there we go, that's pad 1. And then we'll put this on the other side. Oop. Select it first, hit E, and then this is 12.8. Now you'll notice that I had minus 12.8 on one of them and plus 12.8 on the other. And that's because the coordinate system, this is minus XY, this is plus XY. So you need to kind of keep track of all that stuff here. So we have, so now what we can do is we can actually verify. So let's go and change the grid. We'll do it to 0.1 millimeters. We're gonna start at the edge. We can do this in one of two ways. One, we could zoom in. We can mouse over here and say, hey, this is the edge here. I'm gonna hit the space bar. And then watch down here, the DX, DY. We can actually see that zero's out. Okay, so that's now zero. What we should see is that on the far side, on the other side of these pads, we should be able to measure, if I can get over there, that it's 31.1. Let's see. And that is 31.1. Now you see it's a little bit off because the actually my grid spacing, I need to actually do about 0.05, right? Because I kind of split it in two. So, but it is right about there. So 31.1. Now another way we can do that is we can hit Control Shift M, or you can go to the measure menu, click here, and then drag it across, zoom in, and we see 31.1 right to the edge there. So that's a really good way. So this is where the drawings actually, this is actually the point of these drawings is to show, hey, we actually want to verify that these are the right size. And we can do that with the measure function. Similarly, if we wanted to, we can, you know, we actually put it in directly, right? We typed in the size there, but if we wanted to, Control Shift M, click to here, and 5.5, a little bit off there, and zero, right? So 5.5 is the Y dimension there. So we got all this stuff right. One other thing we can do is if we want to, we can actually put in the overall outline. It's a little bit of a weird outline here. Let's see, how could we do that? We could just, so it's 21.1 to here, and then it looks like 20 wide. So we could actually just say 21 by 1. So let's go up to a 0.5 grid, And if we wanted to draw an outline here, right? So we know we want to go 21 wide by 10 by 20 high. So then I know that this is going to be 10.5 and then by 10. See, now I'm in the absolute, this is XY. So I know that I want that to be half of 20 and half of 11, or half of 21 rather. So that's minus 10, minus, there we go. And then I'm just going across. Now I have that grid bigger so that I can kind of start from a good spot there. I want this to be square if it can be. This one's going to be 10.5. Hope I'm doing this right. It helps also to kind of verify it against the edge of that of the pin here. Now what this is silkscreen. So this is what's actually going to be printed on your board, right? So this is the printing process that's used. Remember, these are going to be copper. These are going to be silk, right? And that's actually the white stuff you'd see. So if you have a green PCB or purple PCB, you have something printed in white. You might have the reference designated printed in white. You have the outlines printed in white as well. And that helps a lot of this stuff. Now, another thing we might want to do, and this is something that I didn't used to do in a lot of other, in past Getting to Blinky videos, but I really, really like doing it, is to change instead now to the courtyard. Courtyard is basically saying, hey, this is the extents of this part. Don't put anything within this part's outline. And I'm just going to freehand this one. I'm sure there's a much better way to do this, but I'm just going to freehand this and say, hey, don't go any closer than this. And what's going to happen is then if I do put a part near to the battery, say I put a part that crosses over into this region here, it's just going to throw an error when we do all the checking. And so that's a nice thing to add as well. So I'm going to hit save. We see over here on the left, as I made changes there. So let's, if I undo this, you see, once again, just like the symbols, we have, it has a little star there. I hit Y and I'll hit save. And you see it goes back to good to go there. All right, so I'm going to close out of this. I'm going to go back into my schematic now. This is actually the symbol editor. So here's my schematic. I'm going to mouse over, hit E, and then I'm going to go and select this from our library, which we now should see here, right? So Getting to Blinky 5.0, here's our part. That's what we just drew. That's great. We're going to double click. And now it's added here. And we're good to go. So now the exciting part, we're going to actually go and import this into our layout. So let's go into PCB new. This is back in the launcher now. Make this bigger. Now what I'm going to do, and you remember last time we had this update PCB from schematic. Remember we had an error that says, hey, there's no footprint for the battery. Now that is, this has gone away. You see there's total warnings, no errors. That's great. If we hit update PCB, you can leave all of these default. These are going to change if you update your PCB after the fact. We're going to hit update PCB, hit close, and now we have all of our parts ready to go in here. Another fun thing you can do is you hit Alt-3. This might or might not work. We don't have a board outline yet, but we might be able to see the parts. This is, just calculates what the outline would be. So this is showing all of the 3D models that are default with the library parts. Now you see we don't have one for the part that we created. We could go and create that. We're not going to. That's outside of this tutorial. But you see that now we can see all of these components that we've placed on the board, and then we're going to go and refactor these and move these around in the next video and actually hook them all together. So that's how you create a custom footprint. Hopefully that wasn't too painful. You can see the library management has gotten a lot better from KiCad 4 to KiCad 5.0. If you've, and I guess 5.1 is what we're in right now. And if you've seen the differences there, hopefully you recognize that it's gotten a lot better. I know that I've definitely appreciated it. And the footprint editor in general has just gotten a lot easier to use. So we'll have more videos here. Up next, we're going to be doing the layout and actually hooking all these things together in the physical manner, right? We're actually going to run traces from one component to the next that is defined by the schematic. Remember that was a symbolic representation. Now we're actually going to be hooking up in the physical representation, and then we'll send it off. The last video will actually generate files and send it off to get manufactured. If you have any questions, you can always go to the forum. That's forum.contextualelectronics.com, or you can ask in the YouTube comments down below. If you don't know, Contextual Electronics is a program to teach you more about electronics than just layout, actually. So if you have questions about resistors, capacitors, how to make other footprints, how to make electronics in general, that's kind of what we're going for. So you can always check that out at contextualelectronics.com. That's all for now. We'll see you in the next video of Getting to Blinky.